Well, this afternoon I've got a little bit of time to play with my little engine after getting all the jobs out of the way. But look, what I've done is the other day when I had time, I made a valve. I made an exhaust valve. And the exhaust valve is longer than the inlet, but it actually seats very nicely. But and I've lapped it in and that, but I've got this shoulder here. And the shoulder here is not, it's just not the best practice, I think. And that little collet groove there, that should be down about 60, 80 thou, I suppose. And then this is the inlet valve I made after it. Now you can see with the inlet valve, I've got a radiused edge here now instead of a sharp edge. And the collet grooves in the exact right place. So anyway, I think I'll remake this valve and I'll make it more the design of this one. I don't think the weight, well, in the plans it said to do it like this, and I thought, oh, I might try and make it a little bit lighter, take that extra metal away, but then that gives me a shoulder there. And I'm just not happy with it, so I'm going to revisit that little bit, which is, that's what you do when you're playing with these things. And that's a little cylinder head. You've seen that plenty of times before. And the inlet sits way down in here. And the exhaust just sits up on top there. So they do seal nicely at the moment, but anyway, I think I'll remake it. I'll just be happier in the long run and try and get a better idea of it all. I've got the camera set up now in a new spot too, so hopefully when I get it all sorted out and learn how to drive it all, you'll get a little bit better picture of the machining. So see how we go. Okay, a bit of tidying up stock. You ever got a feeling we've been here before? So we'll keep chugging along. There's 6 metres in the length of this stuff, I think, so we should be able to get a 2-inch valve out of it. Okay, and we're off and racing. I'll see you back when we're somewhere down there 170th hour. Okay, we should be bloody close. Over, yep. A couple of thou up my sleeve if I've done my sums right this time. I stayed awake. Four thou. Beautiful. We'll do another run at that. Be getting close. We're nice and parallel. One thou over. That'll be good. When we polish that, it'll be just how we want it. Okay, we put the dome on here now, and the last time I just did that with the fire. Again for my own peace of mind. Yep. Yep, that's just lovely. It's a firm fit in the head. Okay, we're happy with that. Right, now we have to put a little groove for the collet. A groove for the little bit that makes it stay there for us. Okay, we've got to come up 80 thou. Then do the groove, 125. The 80 was for the thickness of the tip, 2mm tip. It's near enough with what we're looking at. So if I take that there and line him up nicely with the end by eye, that's just beautiful. So we're 170 thou on the stem. We want to get to 1125, so we just got to sneak away. Get my verniers for that gap. Well, we've shifted the camera angle just to see how we go with it, and we've done this first section. We're going to do the next section. It's about 5/8 of an inch long. We're coming down to the final trim, and we have another one section here yet, and then the head. So that's about how we're sitting there. You can see that, so get me fat fingers out of the way. So we'll just try and get this on right on. That's how we get to the final result. Now this should be a couple of thou bigger. Yep, still nice and parallel. One, two, three, four, five thou to go. I thought we were a little bit closer than that. Let's have a feel. About a half a fly shoot, I think. God, it's only about half a thou. We must be running nice and close. Coming good. All right, we'll see how that works. Might get that out of the way first, just for good measure. Yep, look, a little bit of a polish and that'll be nice. All right, the next bit. We've got a few shadows happening here, but anyway, we've got the cross slide set up exactly the same as it was when we made the valve cutting tool still. I haven't moved it, so we're using a nice big radius tool here just to drop a seed in. it a bit of a polish. Not looking too bad. It's starting to look like a valve, really. Right, we'll just take a light skim off the outer. Now we part him off. Can we get in a bit closer? Well, I think that's not looking too bad. We'll see. Focus for you. I'll go and sand that tit off the top. And there you go, there's some valves. So we'll sit this fella in the seat and now we'll lap him in. Lap him in till we get a nice smooth lap. Well, this is what we use for lapping the valves in, just a bit of Holtz fine grade. And what I did when I did it last time, just drop a bit on the valve, pop the valve in the hole, and hook my very own valve pin vise on. It's nearly big enough, isn't it? Might tighten him up a bit more, eh? And we just keep going. You loosen him off from time to time. Bring a bit of the valve grinding paste from the bottom up onto the seat. Pop your little pin vise on. And just keep doing that for a little while. Now, what are we looking for? See that line coming around there? We've got a line that's about a 1/16 of an inch, and it's all the way around. I'm not sure if you can, that might help you see it a bit, but you can see where it's lapped in there. And the reason it probably lapped so quickly is because the I'd already lapped that seat with the old valve, so any high spots would have been off it. So that's not a bad looking valve. Alright, onwards and upwards.